All right, so let's begin. Kamlesh and Rahul have given me this opportunity to run a session with everybody, and I'm very, very excited. The way we'll run this is in three sections. I'll start with a brief introduction of who I am, what my experiences have been, and then we'll jump right into the key topics, which is how has MBA changed my life personally and what you could expect out of it. And then the third section will be a sneak preview into career in marketing. What are the different types of careers that you can expect in marketing, the types of challenges or the opportunities that you see. And of course, afterwards, I'll take up any questions that you have. So feel free to shoot any questions as we go through. All right, so I come from a small town in Haryana. I have been living in Singapore for the last 7 years. I'm married, also to an IMA alum. Now, professionally, I did my engineering in computer science. So I guess engineering is very common to quite a lot of Indians out there. But I guess one difference for me was right from day one of my engineering, I was very, very clear that I want to be closer to business management. And for that, I saw MBA as a critical platform to be achieving that. I still remember my third year and fourth year of engineering completely dedicated to preparing thoroughly for MBA, ensuring that my examinations go really, really well. And once I get the shortlist, ensuring that my GDs, my PIs, etc., go as well as I can perform in them. So got into IMA and then got hired by Procter & Gamble, relocated to Singapore, worked there for 5 years, which was a brilliant experience on multiple brands, started with hair care, Vella, Nioxin, some of the brands that I've worked with, started working on Duracell, and got a very rare opportunity in my career where the brand got acquired by Warren Buffett. I think we've all heard of him as the big investment guru. So currently I'm working as a marketing director on Duracell for Asia Pacific region. So I guess enough about me. Let's deep dive into the first critical question that you all are probably keen to hear about, which is how has MBA changed my life? So some spoiler alert, for me, professionally speaking, MBA is the best thing that has happened to me. And I attribute whatever little success I've achieved in my field of career to MBA. Now, the deep dive of why I'm saying such strong words is, A, when I joined IIM, it was a general management program, which means that the first year, we got very good exposure to all different fields of business management, be it operations, strategy, consulting, finance, marketing, everything. So obviously when you walk into a college, you have the concepts of what these things could mean, but this gives you a chance to real life experience of what these different fields are. You can make a very, very informed decision of where your aptitude is, what your passion areas is, where you think you will have strengths and where you think it's not gelling as well with you. And more importantly, if you want to progress in be it your own startup or be it a corporate life, you need to have an exposure of different spheres of running a business. So it gives you a very good overview of that. Secondly, I feel it equips you with a toolbox where there are a lot of concepts, models, skills, tools that the courses and the teachers train you on. And they help you in problem solving. And trust me, that's why corporates hire you as an MBA. And that sets you apart because they expect you to not only identify the problems early enough, they also expect you to come up with strong solutions and have that strategic thinking to be ahead of your game and achieve the company goals. And MBA will always equip you with a set of toolbox that you can always rely on. It gives you a framework of the thinking, which is very critical to not divert from your course. The third thing I think which I think for those who were there in the last session, which the previous speaker took, he also mentioned about the case studies format or methodology of teaching. And I personally am a big fan of that. And I don't think I realized the value of it as much when I was doing my MBA. I wish I realized even more. Now that I've had 7 years of experience, there are times when I am going through a real life experience on my brand and my business. And I can recall that we did XYZ case on XYZ brand, and that's how we were trying to solve it. So really, the methodology brings you very close to giving a corporate real life experience that gives you an idea of what the world out there is expecting from you. Fourthly, I think the overall curriculum, the teachers, the peers that you have, the relationships that you bond are really for life. Kamlesh and Rahul are actually my batchmates, my very close friends, and we are obviously in touch. We're there for each other if ever we need any type of professional help moving forward, and so is the case for the entire batch who works together. I've even had experiences where I've met people far more senior. I've never met them before, but the fact that we come from the same college helps you strike a chord, and that network of people is just, you just can't put a price to it, because there's no other platform that enables you to have and form that network. I was a fresher when I was doing MBA, and I was craving to have some type of professional experience on my resume, and also as, you know, as a skill set in my kitty, because that enables you to get your dream job and be good at what you're doing. And the teachers are willing to support you for that. So I was lucky enough to do a lot of live projects. If you are willing to go an extra mile, the teachers are there to help you and support you as much as they have. And they have actually a lot of network in the corporate world. A lot of them are actually independent directors. So it gives you very good network. And lastly, and it probably goes back to why I was saying it's the best thing that has happened to me professionally. Because for me as a marketeer, I believe in the power of personal brand, and I do feel that as a person you need to stand for something and you need to have a value proposition. Companies hire you for that. You know, there are a lot of people with great resumes, but for you to build your personal brand is really important. And IMA for me helped me as a launch platform to build my personal brand. Now, no matter where I go, I'm living in Singapore, it's not in India, but some of the institutes have that power, and it will always remain a credential and endorser for you to always build your credibility with wherever you're going ahead. So really, really, I think if one thing you want to take away from this session today, put in your 1000% to prepare well for it, be very, very thorough, and trust me, MBA will be a platform for you to launch yourself into the corporate or your own business world. So that's pretty much what I had to share on the first critical topic, which is how MBA has changed my life and what you could expect out of it as well. Now, deep diving into the career in marketing. So actually, when Rahul mentioned about this session, I started Googling on how Google defines marketing, and I read a couple of definitions. And I didn't think a lot of them resonated 100% with me. So I'm taking an attempt of defining it the way I see it. So for me, marketing is a part of business management that helps companies monetize their products and services to the highest value. Now, why I say that marketing enables the companies to monetize at the highest value? I'll give you a simple example. Let's say you walk into a supermarket and there are two products side by side, right? One plain white bottle with some shampoo on it. The other bottle with Head and Shoulders written on it with the same design that you're familiar with, the white and blue, right? Let me give you that knowledge that both the bottles have exactly same formula, which means in a real world, they actually have exact same benefit to the consumer. Now, I think it takes no genius to guess that consumers are willing to pay much more for this bottle that says H&S or Head & Shoulders than the other bottle. That's the power of brand, and that's what marketing at the core does. Marketing at the core helps you build that ecosystem to build the brand and elevate it to a level where consumers start trusting you and they are willing to take out their wallet and spend on you. So that's in a simple way of how I look at marketing and how this function adds value to the companies and to the shareholders. Now, in terms of when I was studying back 7 years back, we used to read marketing in terms of four P's, the product, place, price, and promotion. I don't think it's as simple as that anymore. I feel it's very, very circular, cyclic type of a chain where you start with understanding what your landscape is. So which category, what the trends are, what the competition is. Then you obviously define your consumer targets within the segmentations and decide who really you want to go after with, what your value proposition is. So what's the product? How do you want to brand it? What does it stand for? What's the pricing and all that? And then finally, how do you bring it across to your consumers and customers via advertising, via digital media, via in-store marketing, public relations? There are a lot of platforms. And once you reach here, you have to start all over again because the world today is very, very dynamic. It doesn't stay the same even for a quarter. Competition is catching up, trends are catching up, consumers are very, very fast evolving. So that's how I look at marketing. Now, some of the specializations in terms of career, they also revolve around this circular chain that I was describing. So one of the specializations that a lot of FMCG giants have, and that's where I have a lot of experience, so can't speak for a lot of other industries, but this gives you a flavor. So one specialization is called market intelligence, wherein you're responsible for data mining, generating credible, robust intelligence for companies to make decisions properly. There are brand managers, product managers, media, you know, experts, creatives, which typically belong to the agency side of marketing, trade marketing, which is responsible for in-store. So really, there's a plethora of specializations around this circle, which is a testimony of how dynamic and, you know, complex this whole circle is. Now, it comes with its own set of opportunities and challenges. For me, two big opportunities that I see, and I think it won't come as any surprises to any of you. One is digital marketing and digital media. I think consumers, this is one area where consumers have evolved far faster than what some of the giants are able to catch up. So there's a lot of capabilities building around this area, which is fast growing, be it advertising investments or be it the consumer consumption. The second area for me is e-commerce. In India, Flipkart, I'm sure you've read in news, there are rumors around Walmart potentially acquiring Flipkart. Amazon is growing really rapidly in India, making a lot of investments. So that goes to show how penetrated this new channel is becoming versus a few decades ago where all of us were only aware of the traditional channel of going down and physically buying something. So those to me are the biggest opportunities out there. It comes with its fair share of challenges. So like I was saying, it is very, very dynamic. So you always need to stay ahead of the curve, always learning and trying to catch up on the latest trends to be relevant. And trust me, a lot of brands actually build their equity and their value by seeming popular. So you have to really catch up on what's happening out there. The second challenge that I personally feel is one of the areas is not everything is going to be black and white. Versus in some careers out there are more analytical based, data based, so you get a sense of what's right versus what's wrong. In marketing, there is a fair bit of data informed based decision, but there's also a fair bit of subjectivity, having that gut based decision making, for which you need experience. We're all learning on it, and that's why we have all these experts in the companies, the seniors, the managers who we look for that. So yeah, you have to be able to be comfortable with a decision making which is not as black and white. So those are some of the areas, guys. I hope it give you some flavor of what MBA does and B, what you could expect in marketing. I'll pause here and I'll open up in case you have any questions or any areas that I probably wouldn't have touched or you want to further discuss. I'll probably give you a minute in case anybody has question and is typing right now, or otherwise I'm happy to end the session afterwards as well. Okay, so I've received a question from Vivek Pandey, and he says, what difficulties did you face during the initial stages of your career? Well, so one area for me was I had never worked before before PNG, and that was really my first experience into corporate. So I think a lot of learning curves around the do's and don'ts in the corporate life, the processes related to a particular company that you have to adopt and learning the culture around it. Specifically in marketing, I think one area that you really have to master before you can start applying all those MBA skills and tools that you've learned is understanding the brand that you're working on. So for me, that was the biggest focus of my first 90 days in my corporate world, which is I was trying to learn as much as I could about the brand I'm working for. So you stay true to the brand, stay true to the roots of it, and whatever plans you make in the future or whatever strategies you define for it, it shouldn't deviate the course of the brand, which a lot of marketeers do these days in the spirit of evolution. So that for me was one of the big focus areas or what I found was very critical for me to understand. The second question I have is from Richa, which is, should I choose marketing instead of HR in MBA, which has more scope? Right, so I guess, first of all, it's very, very different spheres. Two are very, very different spheres. HR has a lot of people management, you know, career building, and a lot of you have to have that soft skills, and there are two parts of intelligence, the emotional intelligence and the IQ basically. And I feel that for HR the EQ is more important than the IQ. So it really is a very different area. Both has very, very strong growth and very, very wider scope. Depends on what your aptitude is. And I guess once you get into an MBA college and if it offers like a general management program, it should give you enough exposure to both the fields, and then you can make an informed decision of where you feel yourself more passionate about. Is it the brand, the business, or the marketing side of things, or is it the people management, seeing them grow, in seeing the companies grow with the retention of the high talent? So really different areas and requires different skills, in my opinion. But yeah, I mean, probably it's one of the areas which you could request Rahul, in case he can get you an expert from HR, because I am not an expert in HR as well. Okay, so the next question I have is from Shikha. How did you come to know that you have to do specialization in marketing? Well, the first year was a mix of all the courses, so operations, strategy, finance, marketing, everything. And trust me, when you go through those courses for a year, it gives you a very, very clear sense of where your aptitude is. So the marketing related courses, I used to love them. And I used to just enjoy doing the case studies. And I could just be up the entire night and I used to enjoy it. Whereas for some of the other courses, without naming it, because it's a public video, there were some courses where I was literally pulling my hair out and I couldn't understand them. And they didn't ignite that passion in me. So I know it's very theoretical at this stage, but really once you get into those courses, once you get into those case studies, it gives you a good enough flavor and you decide. So for me, marketing just resonated a lot more. Okay, I'm just scrolling up. Okay, so the next one is, can we get roles directly in marketing or first we should work? Yeah, so that's an interesting question actually. At least at the time I was in IIM, practically PNG was one of the few companies who was hiring for marketing directly, and there were separate openings for sales and for market intelligence. And PNG was my dream company actually. So I applied for the marketing opening within PNG and got into it. But to tell you the truth, most of the FMCG companies, they have a combined function of sales and marketing. They don't segregate it as clearly as PNG does. So in most companies, I would say, you need to be open to be doing both sales and marketing. And I've seen multiple cases of all types of careers. So I've seen cases where you just do a year of management training program and then you are able to directly get into marketing. But I've also seen cases where people go through the same management training program, but they end up doing sales for like 6-7 years. So it really depends on, most companies will actually club them together. So be prepared to have a sense of it. And honestly, I believe having some bit of exposure in sales do help you be a better marketer, as long as you can manage and be clear in what your aspirations are. And if marketing is your ultimate goal, you should prove yourself in sales and be very vocal about it that you ultimately want to move to marketing. And those are some of the career discussions that you have once you get into it. All right, the next question I have is, what if someone wants to opt for advertising marketing? How should we proceed? Right, so it's very, very possible. It again depends on what type of recruitment companies come to the campus. But even if they don't come directly to the campus, you can always go identify who those key dream companies for you are within advertising. And then you know apply for them out of your campus. But surely, I mean, honestly, I applaud you for having that much clarity that you want to get into advertising marketing. And if you have, then it's brilliant, because then you can be very, very targeted on the skills you want to acquire, on the companies that you want to be. Because again, not wanting to name the companies as such, but there are big companies within advertising world, and even if they don't come to the campus, you can always complete your MBA and apply for them out of the campus. Okay, is it okay if I leave my job for CAT preparations? Well, for me, I would honestly would love to get more background of, you know, what you're doing and what you want to achieve after the MBA, but in a lack of that specifics, I think for me, CAT preparations require a lot of focus and thoroughness and dedication. I was able to do it with my BTech education, but I think for all of those who are engineers out there, I think, you know, if the culture in engineering college and the amount of hours you have to put in engineering is not that much, right? So it allowed me to spend 15 hours in library. I used to just lock myself and study. I honestly could not have done it with the job. and but that's me. All right, so you really have to decide for yourself of where you are in your CAT preparations. And if you think time is becoming a constraint, and if you think that the current job is not satisfying and you need to have that platform of MBA to go to the next level, then yeah, go all out. I mean, I wouldn't shy away, honestly, because for me, putting half-hearted effort is probably more tricky than anything, because you would try your best, but you still wouldn't have enough time to go out for it. So I would honestly just go 100% for it. If it means quitting your job, so be it. You can always come back and get that job, right? So yeah, I mean, I would go 100%. Okay. The next question I have is how my IT work experience would help me in placement interviews in marketing career. So one thing in my personal experience was marketing placements. I was a fresher, right? So I had practically no experience whatsoever. So technically you could argue that an IT work experience is probably more valuable than no experience, right? Because at least you know the professional work experience, the corporate life, culture, and so on. In all honesty, in FMCG type of sector where I'm working, it's not as relevant, to be honest with you. And I think most companies in FMCG would look at you as almost as a fresher, because they wouldn't look at it as a relevant work experience. But you know, back to what I was saying earlier in terms of opportunities, if you look at e-commerce, if you look at digital marketing and so on, there are product-related roles out there in those companies where your technical experience actually matters. So there are specialized roles, I think, where it will become relevant, but there are some roles where I don't think it will be as relevant. All right, how was the transition from BTech to MBA? Well, it was huge cultural shift, because BTech is almost like a party, right? I mean, the first 2 years is very, very chilled out. Third year and fourth year, I was studying for MBA, so I think I was very, very focused, but there were people who were just having the time of their life. So I think BTech is much more chilled out, and I don't think we have as much clarity of what we want to do in life and so on. But I think MBA is very different. MBA people take as a platform, like I was saying earlier, and they know that this is their last chance to gain any skills, to get educated, and they know after this they're going to hit the real world. So people take it very, very seriously. Plus, I think depends on your institute, but like for IMA, even the curriculum was so packed and intense that We almost used to have night out studying, and yeah, I mean, the culture is very, very different. So, but having said that, there are times to, you know, bond and build the network that I was talking about earlier. All right, so the other question I have got is from Rahul, which is, you've been at this company for a while. What keeps you motivated? So in PNG, I worked for 5 years. Then I got transitioned to Berkshire Hathaway, which is Warren Buffett's company, once Duracell was acquired. So what keeps me motivated is I don't want to be stagnated. I don't want to be saturated. That's why I wanted to be in business management. So I can have new challenges, new issues, new problem-solving opportunities every time I come to the job, right? So what keeps me going is, in the last 7 years, I have not hit that saturation, and there are always new challenges, new opportunities, and that's why I love marketing. Sorry guys to be selling marketing so much, but yeah, I'm really passionate about it, and I really think it brings you to the core of business management, and there are always new challenges, new opportunities that keeps you going and keeps you up with that one unanswered question that you want to just crack and get onto it. So yeah, that keeps me motivated. All right, so Ayush has a question, which is, how will you sum up your transition on a professional and personal level? from a pre-MBA life to being an alum of one of the most prestigious business schools. Okay, so the way I look at it, I'll answer this question more in terms of the transition, right? So I think pre-MBA, I was lost. I wasn't sure what I want to do in life. I have an elder brother, so I always looked at him, and whatever he was doing, I thought I'll just do that. So really had no clarity what I want to do in life. MBA gave me that platform where it gave me very clear clarity of if I want to make a career, it's going to be in this field. And it gave all those plethora of opportunities where people are, because, you know, out there in the world, a lot of people struggle with getting a chance to talk to these companies. And if you get into a good institute, it gives you that on a platter almost, because the companies are coming to the campus. So for me, what changed is, in my opinion, it changed my personal brand. I don't think I was anybody. Now at least I have some credentials, and I feel at least I can introduce myself with confidence, and if I want to venture into a new territory, at least the listener will know that I have some credentials in my bag, and probably would be willing to take a leap of faith from me. So I think it helped me build my personal brand a lot more. All right, I have to scroll up for some questions. Okay, Vivek has a question, which is this: I am really set to apart from other equally good colleges. Well, in my opinion, I think there are plenty of good colleges out there, and it's not just IIM. Obviously, see, I mean, I have to be careful of what I say. So, in my mind, there are certain notions and rankings out there which both aspirers like yourself or the companies have in their mind, right? So every college and brand comes with a certain notion of how good they are and where they stand and so on. So in that sense, yes, IIM does help you give that a little bit of notch. So for example, to sort of be specific, PNG, at least 7 years ago, I don't know what's the approach now, but at least 7 years ago, PNG only used to hire from four colleges, and all four of them in India were IIM. So gives you a notch. But having said that, I have a lot of friends from the colleges actually that you mentioned, Vivek, which are XLRI, IIST, SPJAN, who have made great careers in great iconic companies, be it Coca-Cola or be it some of the great financial banks. So no, I mean, aim for the stars. Even if you land on the moon, it's a great place to be, and it sets you apart from millions of people out there. So that's how I look at it. Okay. The next question I have is, according to you, what was the key point of your routine while you were preparing for CAT exam? What helped you a lot? My single enabler was all the live tests that I used to do. So I was doing some coaching, and obviously, just like how Kamlesh and Rahul are investing their heart and soul in, you know, helping you, coach you, giving you all the tips and the tools to crack the exams, one thing that really helped me was to be in that environment and really doing a mock test. Because the first time I did really, really bad. I remember we used to get this Delhi rankings of your mock test, and I don't think I was anywhere. And it took me multiple mock examinations to understand, manage my speed, manage my time, identify what my strengths are, and, you know, where I can be faster and where I am slower, because that's not my strength. So accordingly, what sequences I should take and so on. So yeah, I mean, that worked really well for me, and I'm sure Rahul and Kamlesh are doing that for you as well. I lost track. Okay, Richa. Richa is next, which is, in marketing or HR, which post has more increment in salaries? Okay. How much time it takes or promotion of the post? Well, promotion of the post is really hard to tell, because, you know, it really depends on your own personal performances. There are also different sectors where one function is more critical than the other. You know, there are companies where marketing is the core. There are companies or stages of the company where HR becomes a lot more, you know, important. So I don't think there's a formula or a clear answer as to which of the two have better promotions. Salaries, why don't you ping me one-on-one? I'll answer you more candidly. I don't think it's very appropriate for me to answer it here, but I'll probably answer you offline, Richard. Okay. Siddharth Singh, I want to start a marketing communications agency, and I have always dreamt to start an agency like Salt Marketing, but never got a chance to do MBA. Will I be able to scale it up without having MBA degree? If I have natural marketing skills and I feel I'm good at creating campaigns and IPs and have good PR skills. Well, surely. I mean, there is no saying that you won't be able to. In fact, if you have the passion, if you think you have the skills, MBA is not the only way of doing it. So it's just one of the ways of doing it. In today's world, the digital world, honestly, there's so much to read online, and one can definitely gain all the skills, all the capabilities through those other platforms that are easily available right now. So yeah, I don't think MBA is the only way of doing it. What I would ask myself is, you know, what the competition landscape is, or what's the landscape that I'm playing in? And to be able to win in that landscape with all the other players, what are the brands looking for, and all the other offerings in the market, how will I stand uniquely? That would be my first question of how, if somebody is using agency A, what's that compelling reason for the companies to switch to that agency B, your agency, right? So that would be my first question. And the second question then will be more around the operations of building it, scaling it up. And if you think you have the skills, the capabilities to answer those two and execute those two, then definitely MBA is not the only way, for sure. All right, Abhishek, which specialization is better? Is it HR, finance, or marketing? Very, very subjective, Abhishek. I think it really, really depends on people, on what their aptitude is, what excites them. Because, see, realize one thing, that your work life, be it your own business or be it corporate, is going to be the longest part of your life. I mean, it depends, but sorry, can you give me guys 1 minute? Okay, so yeah, so I think it takes the longest part of your life. So be very, very sure of what you want to do and what you enjoy doing. So I think for me, it was marketing, as I've said earlier, but it depends on you, really. So talk to somebody who has a career in finance, talk to somebody who has a career in HR, and that will hopefully give you a flavor of what you as a person enjoy, and it's really, really subjective that way. Okay, I have the last question out there, which is, how can we sort out to which specialization we belong? Because we only have vague idea on each specialization. I think that's a very fair question. So what helped me was the fact that IIM has a general management in year one. So it gave me that luxury of getting exposed to each of them and make my own informed decision. If you have to choose upfront, there are a lot of colleges where you have to choose upfront. I think I would really leverage Rahul and Kamlesh and their network and talk to those people in different specializations. So for example, I can tell you a lot about marketing. The session last week, I think, gave you some insights on operations. So I'm happy to connect with you if you have any other questions on this field. But yeah, if you have to make a choice upfront, I would just leverage Rahul and Kamlesh and get into their network and try to get some more insights around it. But last thing is, there are a lot of colleges where if you perform really well, they also give you flexibility to move around later, at least it used to be. So that venue is also there as a backup option. Okay, I've just gotten one more question, and that's the last question. So this is from Devesh. What will be more appropriate, proceeding with concentration or approaching with hard work? I'm kind of greedy because I don't want to involve my creative desire and ignore work that is not giving a good salary, and I really want to be in a job. Okay, so, well, creative desire, I think you can fulfill in any field, first of all, because creativity leads to innovation, and any field out there in business management requires innovation. So different types of creativity, but I think that desire you can fulfill in any field of business management. Good salary. So guys, I think I know salaries and monetary gains are a huge part of our career. That's one of the key motivation drivers as well. But I wouldn't make that a key criteria, trust me, because when you have to spend 30 years in a specific career, you do want to ensure you like it, you enjoy it. And, for me, that will be my first question. Because if you're doing something that you enjoy, you'll probably be good at it. And if you are good at it, you will get your due promotions, your due salary hikes and all that. So don't make that your starting point. Make your starting point about your aptitude and your passion area, and then the salaries will follow, trust me. The good companies take care of that. All right, so I've received one more, which is, how many days in a week for cat prep? I'm not very clear on the question, but I think you're asking me how many days did I put in for my cat preparations. Well, I was doing BTech, so that didn't require a lot of effort. So for me, it was all 7 days. And I used to be in library for over 10 hours every day. So yeah, for a period of six to nine months maybe. So put in as much as you can, and put in as much as what takes to give you that confidence that you're ready for it. So I studied till the time I thought I was ready to face an examination as prestigious and as crucial as CAT. All right, so I have no more questions unanswered. So I think that is it. Devesh, thank you as well. And all right, so that's pretty much it. If you guys ever want to reach out to me, I'm on LinkedIn, I'm on Facebook, and you can always reach out to your brilliant two teachers and they will reach out to me. All the best for your preparation. Bye-bye, guys.